through hell, but I still came on number one.
First opened in 1999. There's a good look at First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. The folks here in Cleveland, even though all the down years, have never stopped supporting their hometown guys, and we got evidence of that a moment ago as the Browns made their entrance. They are ready to do battle with the Tennessee Titans. Toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. First carry for Derrick Henry. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. They'll set up a throw. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Grant Delpit, and he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. Chase McLaughlin on for the extra point. It's up and through to make it 7-0 Browns. So the extra point good, and the roughing call going to move the ball out to the 50 for the kickoff.
And I think this is a good chance to pin them deep if you can land the kickoff inside the 5-yard line or so. Gain some field position for your defense.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. He'll drop this one down to Cohen. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. Looking to throw. Being chased out left. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw. And right side, Henry's got it. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll look to throw here. Looking in zone for Jones. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Browns are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 7. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Back to throw now in his own end zone. Dumps this to his running back Chubb, and they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And got his man complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. McLaughlin for the extra point. And it's good. And they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 20.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player.
And here's another interception, the 3rd of this first quarter. Picked off by Grant Delpit, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. They go play action here on first down. Going to throw deep for the end zone, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Caleb Farley. And the Titans are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. To throw here. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Down, he'll drop to throw it. Flush to his right. Throwing right, and that's complete. All that for a 2-yard gain, second down. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So as you said, you shrink the playbook. Pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Here's second and 8. Eluding the pressure right. Looking downfield for Jones. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 14. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember, with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
On to the second from Cleveland. It's the Browns in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. A run for Nick Chubb. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
A good run. Got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And on 3rd and 8, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. 6 defensive backs. They're going to look to throw. A rifle's one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line. A great pick, nice return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind. Going to be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And it's a Titans touchdown. It's the fullback. His second touchdown on the season. And the Titans are able to make this a close game again. Coaches must really like to see that from the quarterback because he's had the interceptions in this game, but they're able to connect on the touchdown pass.
And teammates love to see that because they know that they miss blocks during a game, but they come back and make them later on. They miss tackles, right? They miss making plays. But the spotlight is magnified on your quarterback. And when he stands up to the pressure and comes back and throws a touchdown pass after throwing some picks earlier, they feel great about that guy.
And likewise for him personally, as a rookie quarterback, has to give him more confidence. And he almost flirted with disaster there, but it does get into the end zone before going out, and they'll bring it out to the 25. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They come off a victory over the weekend, but now the quick turnaround here for this Thursday night game. How does that affect how teams like this approach these short turnarounds?
Well, wins and losses always factor into, you know, how you're getting ready for the next game. But equally as important when you have the short turnaround, what is your injury situation? Are you losing key guys? And if so, how well have the backups prepared for this? Because you don't have much time to get them ready. They have to be ready before this week in order to play well in this game.
Second down, here's Chubb again. Fights loose. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, they'll throw. Flushed out right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Here's second and 10. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 47 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point. So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. 46 to Mike. 46 to Mike. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. DJ Moore, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And it's now 21-7. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Got his man. That's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll set up to throw. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 40. Breaks through the contact. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. McLaughlin now to add the PAT. He knocks it through. It's 28-7.
Makes the score Browns 28, Titans 7.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount, here's his opportunity.
It comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? Second down, they go again with Henry. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. And caught by Henry. And he goes out right around the 39.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd went to ballet school. Got the toes down.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Browns are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. The Browns drive about to get started. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look close.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments. And
that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Anthony Schwartz, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Browns are able to widen their lead here in this first half. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And a rout is on here in this first half. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football. Lost a lot of yardage. But I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
So they keep the football, but now face second and long. They'll drop the throw. Looking deep for Julio. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks. The people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what you want. They're having a blast.
And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 19, and he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Browns defense has a touchdown. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good, and a rout is on here in this first half. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And not much happening there as he'll get it back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. A great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps him pick up the first. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. So that one will be accepted. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side, and this is taken in at the 5. Touchdown! David Njoku, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Browns are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good, and that will extend this big lead. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at that time, actually.
You think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10. Stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. Here's Brett Kern now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. 70 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Now Chubb running right, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he will finally be taken down at the Titans 15. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A great effort there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Browns are pouring it on. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And the lead will swell by one more. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And down to a knee. That's one way to call a play. And surprisingly, they take a knee. I have no idea why they would take a knee, but they take a knee. A 3rd down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Here's Brett Kern now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Able to slither by. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. So not quite a 1st and goal. It's 1st.
Oh. Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not my not, my not for less. I fell out and cut the check, my not, my not for lot to set, but I've been taking hits like I can't die like any. One of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it. The nigga, the server, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my gush. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack in my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing you? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality, really, it's up. It's sure, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle in the pick and I hustle. I had to have it. Had to get in the huddle. In the gravel and rubble. Got me a sack and I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun, come with the option. Send big blitz. Nobody blocking big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walk a flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
And the monster tip is out inside of me, so I'm like a product of power.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay.
Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I bought.